congratulations on getting into medical school. Based on the low rate of matriculation into med school, one could argue that the hardest part is now behind you. After all, fewer than 40% of applicants successfully get accepted to medical school in the US. However, I would argue that the toughest part is yet to come. What's going on, guys? Dr. Jabal, MedSchoolInsiders.com. I remember thinking that I was a beast after finishing undergrad and having a highly successful medical school application season. But the beginning of medical school was a rude awakening. I incorrectly thought that since I had figured out how to be an effective student in undergrad, I would find it equally easy to be an effective student in medical school. While med school and college do share several similarities, they require distinctly different approaches. If you haven't already, be sure to check out my college versus medical school comparison video. First, question your current methods. Everything in this video is going to hinge on this foundational principle. One of my favorite quotes is, "Don't believe everything you think." Growth, improvement, and progress require constantly challenging your current mode of operating. This couldn't be more true for the transition to med school. Here are some personal examples that I experienced. In college, I would take notes in PowerPoint and then click through them to study for exams. I achieved great results in college using this terribly inefficient method, but this was even more suboptimal in med school. I go over other study strategies I wish I knew sooner in my pre-med study strategies video, which is the first video I ever made. Link in the description below. In college, I would wake up at different times each day, depending on my class schedule for that day. Some days it was 6 a.m., and other days it was 10 a.m. In med school, I quickly learned that the lack of a regular routine with wake-up time not only resulted in poorer sleep, but it also killed my productivity and momentum throughout the day. In college, I would go to the gym at different times each day without a clear plan. Since I had so much more free time in college, this actually worked. I had multiple free blocks of time where I could leisurely go to the gym. However, in med school, this method resulted in me skipping the gym more often than actually going to the gym. I needed to schedule my gym time and make it a routine, otherwise it just wouldn't happen. Now, the key takeaway is to not grow attached to things that used to work for you. Rather than being attached to certain habits and ways of being, practice being committed to improvement and results. This shift from attachment to commitment will empower you to be flexible and swap habits that don't work for those that do. Number two, prepare for the marathon. Med school is not a sprint. Do you remember the joys of finals week in college? Most of the quarter or semester was pretty relaxed, and then things would get intense during midterms and then again during finals week. While that did work in college, it will not cut it in med school. Now, when I say to approach med school as a marathon, I'm referring to two main areas in life: self-care and studying. With regards to self-care, it is imperative to take care of yourself from the very start. Skipping meals, opting for convenient yet unhealthy foods, skipping the gym, not sleeping enough, these are all habits that may work in the short term, but long term, they will severely limit your potential. Rather, create systems and habits that allow you to eat healthfully around your busy schedule, like meal prep. Schedule time for the gym daily. Make it a routine. In my preclinical med school years, I would work out every day during my lunch break. Create and enforce guidelines for yourself regarding your sleep habits and bedtime. On weekdays, I would start winding down at 11 p.m., and I rarely violated this rule. Remember that the quality of time spent studying is more important than the quantity of time spent studying. Although it may seem counterintuitive, taking time away from the books for a workout, a meditation session, or a good night's rest will actually make med school easier for you. Now, with regards to studying, cramming will not work. First, there's far too much information to get through in a few days before your exam. I had friends who would cram, and ultimately, they did pass most exams, but as the year went on, it got harder and harder for them to keep up. And when it was time for step one, those of us who studied a little bit every day during the year fared far better than those who were cramming. And that brings us to the second point. Content in med school builds off itself. We know that studying a little bit every day is much more effective for long-term retention compared to short bursts of cramming. In college, This isn't as big of a deal, but in med school, everything you learn is far more interconnected and will ultimately be tested on step one and step two. Studying a little bit every day is like compounding interest in finances. The initial benefits may not be as pronounced, but over time you will reap huge rewards. Number three, reassess your priorities. Want to pick up a new sport or three? How about a dance club, a public speaking course, and still going out with your friends every weekend? In college, this isn't too far-fetched. But in med school, you'll have to learn to prioritize. Time is of the essence. When I started medical school, I was excited to try new things with my new friends. I went surfing several times, rock climbing, and I even tried running regularly on the beach. But ultimately, it became more and more apparent that I was spreading myself way too thin. While studying should be a top priority, so should your physical exercise and mental health. I personally prioritize cycling, lifting at the gym, and to get my creative fix, I was a designer and editor at the medical school's literary magazine. And later on in medical school, I also began racing my car at autocross race days. So rather than spending your time in several activities, focus yourself on just a few. Be sure that at least one or more of your activities incorporate physical activity and a social or community aspect. By focusing on depth rather than breadth in your activities, you'll get far more out of them without detracting from your medical school coursework. And number four, embrace your classmates and your community. This tip refers to the cultural shift that you'll experience in med school. In college, you likely had friends in different majors and with different priorities. But when you get to med school, everyone in your class is in the same boat. We're all taking the same tests, we're all working towards the same degree, and we're all studying hard and grinding it out. And most importantly, we're all in this together. Support each other and offer a helping hand when you notice someone struggling. Don't expect someone else to. I personally knew a struggling classmate, and while I initially thought that one of their friends should help them, I ultimately took it upon myself to offer a helping hand. And I'm really glad I did, as I later learned that student didn't have a strong support system. Now on the flip side, don't be afraid to reach out to others, to be vulnerable, to let your shields down. Med school is a trying time, and it is only human to have difficulties at some point. There's no shame in asking for help. Now I want to leave you with this. First, congrats on getting into med school. I wish you the best in your med school career. It's one of the most challenging and rigorous types of higher education, but also the most rewarding. Some of my closest friendships were established and grew from my time as a medical student. Now, while med school is a grind, by following the practices from this channel, you will be well equipped to crush it and ultimately even enjoy it. If you like this video, make sure you press that like button. New videos every week, so hit subscribe if you have not already, and I will see you guys in that next one.